So by now you all heard the wild stories of a Panther tank that was found in somebody's cellar. All coincidence, because the police was looking for stolen Nazi art. And yeah, while they were looking for stolen Nazi art, they had a look in the guy's basement and found all sorts of weaponry, like V1 rockets and an 88mm flak gun, and also a complete drivable and operational Panther. And of course the police, this Panther is lethal because the gun was operational and it was all sorts of things, and it was of course pretty dangerous because that's the police. But if you look closely and do some research about this tank, it's not a surprise that it was in that basement, because it was a private museum and you could just knock on the guy's door and you get a tour of the place. So it was not a big surprise, and it was not like they said in the media that it was a big shock that they found a Panther tank in his cellar. That's all BS. I have no idea if the guy had stolen Nazi art. Maybe he does, maybe he didn't. There are all sorts of wild stories going around, like the guy was selling operational weapons to somebody and that's why they had a look in his cellar and that's why they took everything away from him. And even the mayor said of the town of Heikendorf, hope I'm saying that right, said that the guy was eccentric and was driving his tank around in the snow sometime in the late 80s. But that's I don't think you are going to drive your valuable Panther tank around in the snow for fun. So it's all wild stories on Twitter and on every media site and on Facebook, but it's all a bunch of bollocks. So where did this Panther really came from? Now if you have a look on the internet, you will see that it was built by the British after the war, especially right after the war. It is one of the four Panthers, the Jagd Panthers, that was built by the British army, and it somehow ended up in a scrapyard in Zurich in the 1950s, probably because it was placed as a range target somewhere in the 50s, because if you look on the old photos of 1977 when it was discovered on the scrapyard in Surrey in England, it has all white stripes on it. So that's probably because it was on a range somewhere, because they always place white stripes on it so it can be better visible. And probably it wasn't a hard target because it was pretty complete. And if you look on the old pictures, you can see that the gun was cut in pieces, so that the police say that it was operational and that the gun wasn't deactivated. That's all bollocks, because you can see that the gun was cut up in pieces, and the only way you can have an operational gun was to replace the whole gun, but that's just bollocks. So the gun was unoperational and it was cut in pieces and it will not fire, and if you fire that gun it will just blow apart. It was a restored gun with maybe a tube welded at the end, and that's it. So yeah, so what's further on this story? Now it was discovered in a scrapyard in 1977, in October 1977, and it was transported to Germany. So he bought it from the scrapyard in Surrey, and it was transported to Surrey, and it was restored to running condition and order. So yeah, that's the whole story. It's it was restored by him. It was restored to running condition. They have cut several armor plates off the back, and they removed the ensign, and he replaced everything. And I hope that the Panther will stay with the guy. Hope he will get it back. But if not, I hope they will don't place it in some kind of storage. And I think that they will, because this will end up in court, and the Panther will probably be evidence. So yeah, we probably will not see this thing for a long time, and I hope that's not the case. I hope they will place everything in a museum, and I hope that we all can enjoy this Panther. And yeah, I feel really sorry for the guy that lost it, because like his lawyer said in several news sites, the Panther was damaged when they pulled it out of the cellar of the guy. It took 9 hours to pull the damn thing out of the cellar, and they destroyed all the road wheels, like you can see in some of the pictures, and they damaged the tank at some point of the removal. So yeah, that's pretty sad to hear, because it's a pretty rare tank, and yeah, it should be handled with care. So yeah, it got damaged in the process, and that's pretty sad. But yeah, let's hope all that it will get in a nice museum, or Herr Flick, the guy that owned the tank, will get it back. Yeah, let me hear from you guys in the comments below what you think of this situation, and yeah, I hope you enjoyed this video, and thumbs up.